Texas A&M University-Kingsville Citrus Center scientists, in collaboration with the Texas Water Resources Institute at Texas A&M University and the Texas Water Development Board, have worked together on a program, Irrigation Education and Outreach to the Lower Rio Grande Valley Growers and Stakeholders. The purpose of this video field tour is to demonstrate the impacts of a new and novel planting design for citrus groves that enhance water sustainability and crop production in South Texas. We're located here in the Lower Rio Grande Valley of South Texas at a funded demonstration site by the Texas Water Development Board. The purpose of this project was to look at water-saving strategies for new plantings of citrus. We have four different treatments that we're looking into. We have traditional plantings of citrus that's done on a flat bed, and that's on my right-hand side. On my left-hand side, you see that traditional flat planting with tarp, and that tarp is to reduce evaporation as a potential water-saving strategy for citrus. We also have raised bed with tarp and raised bed without tarp that we'll be showing you. Again, we're at this field site. Now we're in front of the raised bed with and without tarp. So on my far right, we have raised bed without tarp, and next to that, raised bed with tarp. These trees were planted at the same time about 5 years ago. And you will notice that the trees with tarp are higher, fuller, and have more growth than the trees without tarp. We're in a flood irrigated field with raised beds with tarp and raised beds without tarp. In flood irrigation, water will move down the field, soil moves down with that. A lot of times disease moves with the water. And the nice thing about raised bed is we can prevent that water from touching the trunk of the tree. And that can reduce disease. That will end up leading to greater production. And you can notice just how full of citrus fruit we have on this tree with raised bed with tarp. As opposed to the raised bed without tarp, you'll notice that we have smaller trees. We have smaller fruit production. And again, that soil, that water can touch the trunk of the tree and highly impact production.
My name is Judd Flowers. We're the owner manager of Lone Star Citrus Growers. These were planted in the winter of 15. This project is in cooperation with the A&M Kingsville Citrus Center, and we were invited a number of years ago by Mahmoudou and yourself to be involved in the study of raised beds and how they affect the production of fresh citrus here in the valley.
At this location, do you have raised beds and traditional flatbed planting?
Bed cover on raised beds. We have flatbeds with cover, and then we have flat, no beds, no cover.
Do you observe differences in these drip irrigated trees among these planting designs with cover?
We see a big differential in the weed control cost and water savings, and at this point recognize something in the range of a 25% to 35% savings in water.
Are these drip irrigated trees planted at a higher density than is conventional for the industry?
These groves on this farm, all of the new planting is in what we call a staggered row high density planting. We're using 250 trees per acre.
What are some of the benefits for planting on drip systems?
The benefits that we see from drip irrigation is a more timely application of water, that the water becomes a vehicle. So whatever you're trying to apply to the orchard, be it nutrient or these bioproducts, also herbicide, fungicides, everything that you put on the tree that goes on the bottom can be applied through the drip lines.
With the recent hurricane, did you observe any differences in this site with tarped raised beds compared to other field locations?
One of the side issues with flood irrigation is, especially in the summertime, which happens to coincide with hurricane season, is the water table. And the whole valley has a tendency to have a high water table. Most of our roots in the citrus production area are in the top 3 feet of the soil. And so if your water table encroaches on that 3 foot section, it has a lot to do with the thriftiness of the tree. So in a intensive irrigation part of the year, which is in the summertime, a frequent application of flood water tends to raise that water table. And you're pushing all the time to get enough water on it to have the fruit size up for early pick in the fall. Unfortunately, if you have a hurricane come at the same time, you're going to raise that water table even more. So the experience we had recently was in this neighborhood, we had a 2 foot rain. And some of our orchards that are in a flood format had a high water table, whereas the orchards that are in the drip format, the water table was maintained at a lower level because you put on less water more frequently. So that water table maintenance issue really didn't apply in the hurricane situation that we just came through.
How has adoption of this raised bed tarp practice occurred in the valley?
This year we've planted about 300 acres and we did it all like this. The citrus can become a pay me now or pay me later situation. If you have a long-term view of the industry, then I think utilizing your capital in an upfront measure to modify your growth care expenses over the life of the orchard can be a benefit. Of course, it depends on what happens next, like most things. But for our purposes, the increased cost of labor, the availability of labor, the increased cost of water, the water supply in the valley in the future, the cost of chemicals and how you have to get them on. I think if you add all those things up together, that there's a pretty substantial logic behind using bed cover and in most cases maybe raised beds as well.
Part of some sound agronomic practices is to minimize weed competition. Weeds compete for nutrients that we apply for the tree to be able to have increased production. And you'll notice that in this raised bed planting without tarp, and even in the plantings where we don't have tarp, whether on the flat or raised bed, we have weed competition. We're losing nutrients, it's taking up excess water from the root zone, and so we have lower sized trees in these areas compared to the raised bed with tarp, where we eliminate that or minimize that competition. One of the challenges we have with traditional planting without tarp is weed control. And you can see behind me a great example of one of the major problems for citrus is vine control, which can grow over and choke the entire citrus tree.
Jose Silva, General Manager for Edinburgh Citrus Grow Care.
Why was there a decision made to select this location for raised beds with ground cover planting when the rest of the farm was planted with flat beds without ground cover?
We're standing here because here we have trees planted on high raised bed with the row cover, and right next to that row we have a flat planted standard practice flat planted trees.
What advantages do you see with raised bed with ground cover?
I think there's a lot of advantages. One big one is the weed control. We have a less of a weed pressure. As you can see over here to the left, we have some weeds and we're always battling those weeds, always. We're in the row cover. So there is a significant amount of water savings. Water these trees over here a lot quicker than the ones in row cover. So there is some water retention going on.
So the ground cover is preventing evapotranspiration?
The wind and the temperature, that we have high temperatures here, these trees really go through, that evapotranspiration rate is very high. With the high winds we have in South Texas, we have a lot of wind that blows. Just to give you an example, the moisture probes that we have, and I talked to you about the temperatures that we monitor, The temperatures, for example, in the top 0 to 4 inches on the row cover could be, let's say, 105. And the temperatures on the flat ground over here, it could be maybe a little bit higher, 110. But then it dries up faster over here. When you put the water on, it dries pretty fast. We're over here in the row cover, even though you have high temperature, the water is up there in that top 0 to 8 inches. So what that means is in a tree, in a flat planted row versus a high row cover, is that the tree has to draw water from deeper on these flat bedded planted trees. They have to draw because the top 4, 5, 6 inches is drier than these over here. So these trees are pulling water from the top 0 to 8 inches. So it is an advantage.
What is the impact of the ground cover on tree health and tree growth?
If you go down the row where the row cover ends, you'll see the trees drop in size. So there is some initial growth early on. So as you can see, the difference here, and even if you can really key in on the leaves, the flat planted rows here, see how the leaves are kind of wilted? Look at these, they got moisture.
Do you think this is a good method to adopt for planting young citrus trees in South Texas?
Cost is a factor, as we know. A lot of growers, especially the mom and pop growers, they're not gonna go this direction. But there are big companies out there that need to go this route because that's the future of the citrus down here.
How many acres of new citrus have been planted in raised beds with ground cover by your company?
300 acres of new plantings, of which about 50% of them are raised bed and row cover. And we also are scheduled to be planted next March 2 more 100 acres, and that's going to be the raised bed row cover.